Donna, let's begin with the controversy over mail-in ballots.
Yes, the coronavirus has really proven to be a catalyst for a pretty well-funded campaign trying to drive up mail-in absentee voting in some cases, maybe had calling to hold an entirely mail-in election. That's something a lot of folks, including President Trump, have really opposed. But part of the challenge of this is keeping those safeguards in place to make sure any absentee ballots are legitimate. And that about last election, about 5% of North Carolina voters used the absentee ballot system. They expect that that will probably increase in 2020. The North Carolina State House passed a bill this week that would create a portal for people to request and return mail-in ballots. They can return them by fax or email or regular mail. But this challenge really is something we're going to see a lot more of, just because, you know, a lot of people are concerned about fraud in the absentee system and keeping those safeguards in place. This House bill still needs to be approved by the Senate, but it would forbid doing an all mail-in election in North Carolina. But then it really has to go to Governor Cooper for final approval. And that's something a lot of folks are going to be watching.